Hi, it's Tegan here from the Department of Agriculture and Fisheries. Today I'm here with David East, who's a plant pathologist based at the South Johnston Research Facility. We're going to be having a talk about managing yellow sigatoka. So Dave, how is yellow sigatoka managed on banana farms?
So currently yellow sigatoka is managed with a combination of fungicide applications and inoculum reduction by deleafing. Mm-hmm. Fungicides alone will not solve the problem, and you need to reduce the inoculum by putting the spots on the ground.
Can you tell us a bit more about these fungicide spray programs that are used, David?
So the fungicide programs consist of protectant and systemic products. Mm-hmm. To reduce the risk of fungicide resistance occurring, some chemical groups have a maximum number of applications that they can have per annum and a maximum number of consecutive sprays. Some groups also have a no-spray period during the winter.
Can you tell us the difference between the protectant and the systemic fungicides, David?
So protectant fungicides like chlorothalonil and mancozeb, mm-hmm. The best way I can explain it, I think, is to say it's like a sunscreen. It provides a barrier to stop the disease occurring. So it's important to apply your protectants before the presence of the disease is in the crop. The timing between spray applications may need to be reduced in high leaf emergence periods. In those periods of fast growth, you need to use the shorter periods on the label, and in as it slows down in the winter, you need to extend out to the longer periods. Remember, if you can see spot, then the protectant fungicides aren't going to work.
So that's some great information about the protectant fungicides, David. But can you tell us a bit more about the systemic fungicides that are used?
So systemic fungicides such as propiconazole and tebuconazole are only effective on your early stage lesions. So anything before 2B. If you spray after 2B, mm-hmm. All you're doing is wasting your spray, it won't work, and you're promoting resistance by putting it on.
Okay, so what's really important there is that if you're putting it on, it needs to be put on those 2B stages, which are that that early streaking. So if you can see spots, it's not going to be effective.
Cut them off, put them down on the ground, yeah. And another important thing with the systemics is they should be applied with a paraffinic spray oil. Mm-hmm. The paraffinic oil has been shown to delay fungal growth, and it also increases the performance of the systemic fungicides.
So deleafing, David, can you tell us how important that is to be part of that management system?
Deleafing is a critical part of leaf spot management in bananas. The process of deleafing is removing the inoculum from the canopy, so you're stopping that reinfection of your crop as well as stopping it spreading to your neighbours. Deleafing needs to occur in the wetter, hotter months at around 6 to 8 weeks. Mm-hmm. Of course, if you're going to apply a systemic fungicide, you need to deleaf before that happens. And then that can be pushed out to 3 months, perhaps in the winter time. It just depends really on the environmental conditions at the time.
David, so deleafing is obviously very critical from what you've just said, mm-hmm. As is the appropriate use of fungicides. What else is important for managing this disease?
Your block design. When you're doing your block layout, you need to avoid things like water bodies and dams. They'll only promote the disease because of the high humidity that's associated with them. Lower planting densities will promote a drier microclimate within the crop, which will reduce the favourable conditions for the disease. Having good drainage within your rows just to get the water to run out so that you don't have those standing patches of water where you get those really humid little microclimates. Also regular desuckering to improve airflow so that you don't have that humid microclimate within the understory.
In summary, David, what do you think are the key points in regards to managing yellow sigatoka?
First and foremost is that you can't spray your way out of a problem. You need to get the spot onto the ground. If you're not, then all you're doing is reinfecting yourself and your neighbours as well. You need to also make sure that you're using your fungicides appropriately. Deleaf before you apply your systemics. Otherwise, you're just wasting your money and promoting resistance. Finally, growers need to utilise that winter spring period where you've got slower leaf emergence to get ahead of the infection so that it puts the growers in a good position going into summer and into the high disease pressure time of year.
I just want to thank you very much for your time today, David, for sharing your knowledge about yellow Sigatoka and managing it. We really appreciate your time.
No worries, thanks.
Thank you.